Hi, Dr. Bernard here. This video is based on a medical case series published in Literature. It was a collaboration with the US CDC to drive more clarity regarding certain food products. We do still come across the issue of people getting hurt in a similar way almost every day for different reasons. So, my purpose here is to teach you science and medicine by telling you this story. A dad ate horrible food cooked by his daughter. This is what happened to his organs. XD is a 45-year-old man presenting to the emergency room with lightheadedness and dizziness. When he tried to stand, he could feel the floor start spinning and he needed to sit down. 3 days ago, XD was visiting his son June and his daughter Ivy. Ivy had cooked a delicious meal to celebrate this joyous occasion. She had cooked so many dishes that when everyone was done eating, they noticed that there was an entire dish that no one had eaten. They were so busy with all the other delicious dishes that they hadn't even touched this one. XD packs them up to save as leftovers for lunch on another day. The remainder was given to June to have as a lunchbox too. 3 days later, XD started eating these leftovers. At first, it was a succulent dish, typical of what he knew his daughter to make, but as the minutes pass, XD started feeling all the problems that brought him to the emergency room now. At examination, XD had tachycardia, tachy meaning fast, and cardia referring to heart rate. He also had hypertension, hyper meaning high, and tension referring to blood pressure. The medical team put a pulse oximeter on his finger in order to check the oxygen saturation in his blood. That is, the measure of how much his hemoglobin, that's the protein in red blood cells that's supposed to carry oxygen, is actually carrying oxygen. The pulse oximeter shines a light and measures how much remaining light is received on the opposite end to determine that percentage of oxygen absorbed by his red blood cells. For XD, his oxygen saturation was abnormally low. Given that he also has tachycardia and hypertension, it means that something is happening inside his body. During the exam, XD became somnolent. His heart rate decreased from 140 to 35. His blood pressure severely decreased. His oxygen saturation kept going down despite them giving him oxygen. Unconscious now, XD's skin was pale gray and he was cold to the touch. Minutes pass. While doctors were checking XD's medical record to see if he had any past illnesses, his heart suddenly stops beating. He has no pulse, but electrical activity is still happening in his heart. The hospital loudspeaker announces a code, and doctors rush into his room to do CPR to try to resuscitate him. When a pulseless electrical activity, or PEA, cardiac arrest like this happens, an electric shock from the defibrillator won't bring the patient back. Adrenaline, given during chest compressions, can bring the patient back. But while the heart stopped, blood doesn't get to the organs anymore. It will starve them of oxygen, causing permanent damage, especially to his brain. But why did this happen? PEA arrest can happen for a variety of reasons. Given that XD was struggling to get enough oxygen in his blood, it means that his heart couldn't get enough oxygen to make energy to contract. Even though he was being given oxygen, he had become gray and cold to the touch. This means that something was wrong in his blood. XD's resuscitated, but now he has hypotension, low blood pressure, and bradycardia, slow heart rate. Ivy and June arrive at the hospital to see their dad. June had packed a lunch. It was the vegetables from 3 days ago. When he ate it, it was delicious, and no one thought anything of it. He finished the whole lunchbox. But minutes pass. It started getting harder for him to breathe. He started becoming lightheaded and dizzy, and his field of view became dark. Ivy calls for help. The doctor takes a quick look and notices that June has all the same symptoms as his dad. Given that they both ate the same food, and that Ivy was the only family member who didn't eat it, something was wrong with those vegetables, but what? The dish that she cooked wasn't anything out of the ordinary, but maybe this batch had a problem. Maybe someone did something to them. Maybe something else associated with the vegetables got in. This means that other people might somehow come into contact with this now and get sick like this too. The hospital calls the Centers for Disease Control to notify of a potential outbreak. An investigation is quickly opened and more details are collected. When doctors drew XD's blood so that they could test it, they noticed that it was an abnormal chocolate color. It wasn't red like it's supposed to be, bringing us back to the idea that something was wrong in his blood. Red blood cells hold on to oxygen because they can keep a particular form of iron. This iron is why blood is red. Chocolate-colored blood means that something happened to that iron. It can't hold on to oxygen anymore. This started choking his brain out, explaining why he was dizzy and lightheaded. This starved his heart of oxygen, causing it to collapse into pulseless electrical activity cardiac arrest. It links everything together. But understanding that this happened gives us some clues as to what caused this. Iron is a metal, and metals can shuffle electrons. In the physical world, we see this as electricity, but in the body, this movement creates electrical chemical reactions that are part of our normal function. To move electrons, the iron atom can have a different number of electrons at any given time. When iron is missing two electrons, it can hold on to oxygen. This is the iron that we have in our red blood cells, but iron that's missing three electrons can't hold on to oxygen. We don't want this in our red blood cells. Iron, too, has room to connect with oxygen, and during its time with oxygen, it exists as iron 3. If the iron in red blood cells is already iron 3 without being connected to oxygen, then there's no room for oxygen to connect. A version of this, slightly different, happens outside of the body that you might be familiar with. When iron rusts, it's oxygen and water oxidizing it. While rust is forming, the oxygen and the water are removing iron's electrons, creating iron 3. So in a way, what's happening to XD and June is that the iron in their blood are getting oxidized, kind of like if their blood was rusting. It's not iron 2 anymore, something changed it to become iron 3. This explains the chocolate-colored blood. It explains why all of their organs aren't getting enough oxygen now and are shutting down. And this gives us enough to know why these two patients are sick, bringing us back to the CDC investigation. Ivy was contacted. At her house, the inspector asked a few questions to get an idea of how everything went down. Ivy had prepared all the dishes in her kitchen. All of the involved ingredients were collected. At XD's workplace, at his desk, the inspector found the vegetable dish that made him sick still out in the open. And when lab tests were done, they found out exactly what happened. Hey, I got a quick question. If you like this video, I wanted to let you know. I publish once a month, and I try my best to make each video worth your time. And if you do find this valuable, I'd love it if you subscribed and come back to see my next video too. Certain foods contain a chemical called nitrite. They're used as a preservative, and they help prevent the unwanted growth of organisms. Nitrite is a chemical made of nitrogen and oxygen. It has an extra electron. When nitrogen and oxygen are arranged like this, they want to become more stable by getting rid of that electron. This extra burden causes problems in the body. Oxygen can accept extra electrons, and we're constantly breathing it in. When nitrite forces oxygen to take this electron, the oxygen becomes superoxide. The body doesn't want this around, so it neutralizes it. But the problem is, the result of this is hydrogen peroxide, which the body still doesn't want around. Hydrogen peroxide takes an electron from iron 2, of which is most abundant in the hemoglobin in blood. It leaves behind iron 3, turning hemoglobin into methemoglobin, which can't hold on to oxygen. And this is where the extra burden kicks in. Typically, the body can handle extra electrons. The issue is, in the body, it continues to cycle this reaction nonstop, turning most of the hemoglobin in the body into methemoglobin. And this is where the problem with their blood came from. The body lives in a balance. Normally, some hemoglobin does become methemoglobin. It's not a lot, but it happens. So many things happening all at once in the body that the conversion just happens sometimes. It's just that the red blood cells have a mechanism that overwhelmingly change it back to maintain hemoglobin as the norm. One of these mechanisms is related to sugar. Red blood cells only live for about 4 months before a new one is made to take its place. They don't divide, they don't have genetic material. They also don't have mitochondria, meaning that their energy exclusively comes from just the breaking down of sugar, glycolysis. In normal cells, glycolysis feeds a further pathway to produce much more energy. Glycolysis branches off to produce an antioxidant that helps maintain electron balances on the iron. When there's methemoglobin, antioxidants here restore hemoglobin. But when the oxidant stress becomes too much, the body just can't keep up. There's one more option to help fix this problem, and the body just needs a little bit of help. During glycolysis, another chemical reaction can start to happen and branch off from it. This also produces a different antioxidant named NADPH, and this is where an antidote can work. Methylene blue is a chemical. It's a colored dye that wants to take electrons. When methylene blue is injected into the body, NADPH gives it that electron. During this reaction, methylene blue loses its color and becomes the clear leucomethylene blue. It then gives that electron it took to iron, restoring hemoglobin to its functional state and becoming methylene blue again. And just like how nitrite cycles its electron-stealing reaction, methylene blue cycles its reaction over and over and over again until the majority of met hemoglobin is converted back to hemoglobin, allowing oxygen to be delivered again throughout the body. This is something that we're seeing more people talking about, including the health secretary in the United States in 2025. I talk more about this in depth on my second channel, Heme Review, link in the description below. Doctors saw XD get progressively sicker in the hospital before they even gave him anything. He went from cyanosis and somnolence to cardiac arrest with chocolate-colored blood because of a toxic ingestion. In the hospital, XD and June were given methylene blue antidote the moment that the medical team saw chocolate-colored blood following XD's cardiac arrest. At the CDC laboratory, scientists found that a bottle of what was supposed to be sugar was actually sodium nitrite. This was one of the bottles from Ivy's kitchen. Ivy had cooked the vegetables with this, making a local cuisine that was typical and popular. Because it wasn't eaten by anyone during the dinner, no one had gotten sick, and Ivy didn't use the sugar in the preparation of any other dishes. When the leftovers were eaten, the vegetables still had sodium nitrite in them, and both XD and June got sick, unaware of this contamination. When the CDC inspector asked Ivy, she mentioned that a few weeks earlier, she was helping clean a friend's house. She found an unmarked plastic bag of what she thought was sugar and brought it home to use it to cook. It looked like sugar, and this is what caused the accident. In the hospital, June was lucky that his illness was identified early. Prompt administration of methylene blue in this case prevents permanent damage. However, XD's case was a little bit different. Given that his illness wasn't caught early, that his heart stopped beating, and he was unresponsive after he was resuscitated, his body was cooled with bags of ice to help maintain the integrity of the blood-brain barrier and to help improve survival. But while sodium nitrite shouldn't have been used in the vegetable dish that Ivy was making, it is used in the preparation of cured meats and sausage. Keep in mind that nitrites and nitrates are two different chemicals, and some foods can have both. And this isn't to scare you. The normal nitrite amount in these meats isn't going to cause methemoglobinemia. It's just when you put large amounts thinking that they're a different ingredient that it becomes a problem. In the United States, sodium nitrite is usually dyed, often pink, so as to notify the user that this isn't salt and this isn't sugar. Sometimes you'll see people telling you to take methylene blue as a supplement. You might see some fancy dances and a bunch of smiles. Now, I might feel good sometimes when I'm taking my multivitamins, but I can't ever say I felt so good that I've needed to dance on camera about it. And I don't want to dunk on this too hard, but there are some legitimate reasons why you don't want to put something like methylene blue in your body if you don't need to. You'll see people on social media talk about this, that it's an MAOI, a monoamine oxidase inhibitor. That's an antidepressant, a very old one. It does do that, but given that this isn't its primary mechanism of action, we'd mostly refer to that aspect in terms of adverse reactions and not therapeutically, because we don't really use MAOIs as medicine anymore. But why? It's because they have very many interactions with food and other medicines, one of which are serotonin agents, which are also antidepressants. Fatal serotonin syndrome has been reported with methylene blue while someone is taking a serotonergic medicine. Also, paradoxically, when too much methylene blue is taken, it can actually cause methemoglobinemia because remember, by itself, it is a chemical that takes electrons away. And that's what happens to iron in hemoglobin. And too much methylene blue will overwhelm the system, causing toxicity. So the dose makes the poison. The publication that this video was based on was able to make the recommendation that food-grade sodium nitrite products be dyed a bright color such as red, blue, or yellow to avoid mistaking it for plain salt or sugar. It's being followed now, although as of 2025 in the United States, the red 3 used in some products has now been banned. For anyone who wants to lose their mind in the comments about this, and I highly encourage you to do so, just check out the date of the announcement. And if that still doesn't make any sense to you why I'm telling you to look at that date, please feel free to lose your mind in the comments a second time. Happens to me every day. Companies will reformulate, so there's going to be other sources of red that we can get. In the hospital, XD and June responded to the methylene blue antidote for their accident. Luckily for them, they were able to get the treatment that they each needed in time for their particular case in order for them to make a full recovery. More info on methylene blue in this video on my second channel, Heme Review. Thanks so much for watching. Take care of yourself and be well.